Everyone, I'm Vikram Salunkar. Welcome to the x86 assembly. This is a video number 30 and part number 5 of a local variables and argument passing. In this video, we'll continue our execution in animation format. So let's get started. We are executing from function. Now function needs to start its own stack frame onto the stack to save its local variables, registers, etc. And EBP always point to the stack frame pointer. Currently, EBP is pointing at 0012FF68. That is a main stack frame. So first we will save that onto the stack. For that we will push EBP. That got pushed onto the stack. Next instruction is move ESP into the EBP. Currently ESP is pointing at the 0012FF4C and EBP will move there, and from this point it will all function stack frame. Now let's analyze our stack. This is a function stack frame. This is a main stack frame and it contains main's local variables, registers, arguments that pass to the function, etc. And this is an initialization function stack frame who called main. Now as we can see, our viewing area is full. We will only see stack from this point and I will hide these elements, and when we return to the main I will show these elements. Okay, let's see stack from only this point. Now next instruction is subtract 10 from ESP. As we can see, our function has 4 variables: integer x, integer y, integer var1, integer var2, and for that function needs to reserve space onto the stack, and decimal value of a 10 is a 16. We need to allocate 16 bytes onto the stack because each integer variable needs 4 bytes. For that we need to subtract 10 from the ESP. Currently ESP is 0012FF4C. Let's execute that. Okay, space got allocated, 4 variables onto the stack. Next main is saving arg1 into the integer x. For that, value pointed by a pointer arg1 will get moved into the EAX first. That got done. Next, that EAX will get moved into the address pointed by a pointer x. That got done. Next function is saving arg2 into the y. For that, value pointed by a pointer arg2 will get moved into the ECX. That got done. Next, the value of a ECX will get moved into the address pointed by a pointer y. Let's do that. It got moved. Next function is defining new variable integer var1 equals 3. For that, 3 will get moved into the address pointed by a var1. Let's do that. Next function is declaring new variable integer var2 equals 4. For that, 4 will get moved into the address pointed by a var2. Let's do that. It got moved. Next function is written with the var2, and as we saw in a CTKL video, EAX register contains the return value. So the value pointed by a var2 will get moved into the EAX. The value pointed by var2 is 4. That will get moved into the EAX. That got done. Now function is ending here. And as we can see, the function has some data on a stack and function is responsible to clear up this data. To clear up this data, the value of a EBP will get moved into the ESP and those 4 will automatically get cleared from the stack. Let's execute that. EBP is at 0012FF4C. That value will get moved into the ESP. And ESP is now at 0012FF4C. And the data got cleared from our stack. Now, as we can see, function is returning to main and we will need main stack frame. So let's get back main's data. It is a main stack frame. Now function is returning to main. First, function will give back main stack frame pointer back, and main stack frame is 0012FF68. That will get into the EBP, and EBP will point there. Okay, we pop the top of the stack and we put that into the EBP, and as we can see, now EBP contains the main stack frame pointer. The next instruction is a return instruction. To execute the return instruction, the return address pointed by the ESP will be put into the EIP, and EIP will continue execution from there. The address pointed by the ESP 00401051 will put that into the EIP, and EIP using that address will return to the main. We have returned to the main using the same return address which we took from the stack, and now we will start the execution from main. The first instruction is add 8 into the ESP. Now, as we saw earlier, main passed 2 arguments to the function, so it is a main's responsibility to clear those from the stack, because as we saw in the cdecl video, the caller is responsible to clean up the stack, and in this case main is a caller and function is a callee. The decimal value for 8 is also 8. We will take the ESP, that is 0012554, we'll add 8 bytes into it, and the address which we'll get is 0012FF5C, which is here. So using this logic, main will clear these two elements from the stack. Let's execute that. So we clear these two elements from the stack. Next instruction is move EX into the address pointed by a pointer value. Let's recall, when main called function, it passed two arguments A and B, and now main is saving the result into the integer value which passed by the function. And as we all know, the EX register contains the return value, so we will save that into the address pointed by a pointer value. EX contains 4, that is a return value which returned from the function, and now it got moved into the address pointed by a value. Next, main is returning with the ones. For that, those 1 will get moved into the EX. Now EX contains 1's main's return value. Now main is ending here. So it is main's responsibility to clear up this stack. How the stack will get clear? For that, value of EBP will get moved into the ESP. Value of EBP is 0012FF68. Currently ESP is pointing at the 0012FF5C, and when the value of EBP will get moved into the ESP, ESP will point at 0012FF68, and that's how this space will get clear. Let's execute that. Okay, so by moving EBP into the ESP, main cleared its stack frame. Next instruction is pop EBP. That means top of the stack will get popped into the EBP. Currently top of the stack is 0012FFB8. That value will get popped into the EBP, and EBP will point at 0012FFB8. Why we are doing this? Because main is returning to the function who called it, and we call that function as an initialization function. It is main's responsibility to queue back the calling function its own stack frame pointer back. Let's execute that. Okay, currently now EBP is pointing at the 0012FFB8, and that is a stack frame pointer of an initialization function who called main. Next, main is returning. For that, the top of the stack, that is 0040-1328, will be moved into the EIP, and EIP will begin execution there. The value 0040-1328, it is a return address of a function who called main. Let's execute that. Okay, main is returned to that function, and EIP will now start execution from 0040-1328. We will stop our execution here because this is beyond our scope of a program. That's it for this video. I hope you understood everything clearly. If you have any suggestions, any feedbacks, please do write me on vikram@vmoscas.com. It motivates me to make a new video for you guys. Thank you.